Hi, hello, once again I welcome you to SPP Math Russia. Today in this video we will discuss about quadrilateral and different types of quadrilateral. Based on the nature of the sides or angles of a quadrilateral, it gets special names. There are different types of quadrilateral. According to the sides and angles, it has been classified. First one we have trapezium. We have first one trapezium. Another quadrilateral we have kite. Next we have parallelogram, fourth one rhombus, fifth one rectangle, last we have square. These are the different types of quadrilateral. Let us learn the definition of trapezium and its properties. First let us write, what is trapezium? Trapezium, first one. Okay, how will you define trapezium? Trapezium is a quadrilateral. You know, these are all quadrilateral with four sides. Trapezium is a quadrilateral with four sides. It has one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Trapezium is a quadrilateral with one pair of opposite sides are parallel. We have the trapezium here like this. This is the trapezium. The opposite sides are not equal. We know that one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Here we have ABCD is a trapezium. AB parallel to DC. One pair of opposite sides are parallel, but AB and DC never equal. They are not equal. Their opposite, one pair of opposite sides are parallel. That is called trapezium. But we know that trapezium, these two angles are coincident angles. Considering AB and DC are the parallel lines, AB and DC parallel lines, BC is considering as the transversal. Therefore, this is called they are coincident angles. Always we know that angle B and angle C will be angle B plus angle C will be always 180. We have a pair of parallel sides AB and DC. This considering this is a transversal, B plus C will be always 180. Again, another one more pair is there, coincident angle. This is coincident angle sum is co-interior angles 180. Sum is 180. Another one more pair is the co-interior angles. Angle A plus angle D also 180. Co-interior angles. Co-interior angles sum is 180. We have two pairs of co-interior angles. These are the angle B and angle C will be always equal. Angle B and angle C sum will be always 180. Angle A and angle B sum will be always 180. They are co-interior angles. Okay, we have our next one, quadrilateral is kite. Kite is a quadrilateral. Let us see what are the definition and properties of a kite. How will be the kite? Kite is also a quadrilateral. Kite is also a quadrilateral. Kite is a quadrilateral with exactly two pairs of consecutive equal sides with a two pairs of consecutive equal sides. This is a kite. Kite is a quadrilateral with exactly two pairs of consecutive equal sides. These two are equal. These two are equal. These two are equal. This definition. Kite is a quadrilateral with exactly two pairs of consecutive equal sides. Now you have to realize one thing, that each quadrilateral had different properties. Already we have learned about trapezium and its properties. Trapezium is a quadrilateral with exactly one pair of equal sides. Only one pair of parallel sides, not equal, one pair of parallel sides. That is, then co-interior angle sum is 180. Since they have a pair of parallel sides and a transversal, we have learned the co-interior angle sum is 180. Next quadrilateral we have kite. Kite we have, let's see the properties of kite. Kite diagonals are always perpendicular. Kite we have two diagonals. These two diagonals are always perpendicular to each other. That is the first property of a kite. Now there is another property for a kite. Kite have one of the diagonals will bisect. Bisect, you know, this diagonals will be bisected. These two, it has divided two points. This diagonal will be bisected. This length will be equal. Another diagonal will not bisect. Only one diagonal will bisect. Two properties we discuss. First property, diagonals are perpendicular. Diagonals are perpendicular. And the second property, one of the diagonals Both the diagonals will not bisect, only one diagonal will bisect. Third property we have, we can see two pairs of angles here. Always this is a pair of, this is obtuse angle. This will be acute angle, less than 90. These two angles will be always equal. Okay, let us name A, B, C, D. We have this one pair of opposite angles are equal. Measure of angle B will be always equal to measure of angle D. That you can see from the figure itself. Since they are obtuse angle, no, they are more than 90. This is less than 90. This pair will be always equal. These are the main properties of a kite. Okay. Okay. Next we have parallelogram. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral. How do you define parallelogram? We have already discussed about trapezium and kite. How can you define the parallelogram? Parallelogram is a quadrilateral whose opposite sides are parallel. Both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. But whereas in trapezium we learned that only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Whereas in parallelogram, both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Parallelogram is a quadrilateral whose opposite sides are parallel. We have AD and DC parallel. AD and BC also parallel. They have two pairs of parallel sides, opposite sides. AB and DC parallel, AD and BC parallel. If they are parallel, since DC and AB are parallel, we know that these two angles are called the coincident angles. Two lines intersect by a transversal, we will be getting two pairs of coincident angles. Alternately, intersect angles on the same side. Intersect angles on the same side of the transversal 180. Since they are parallel, sum of these two angles will be always 180. Sum of adjacent angles, coincident angles, sum is always 180. Now let us come to the property. Parallelogram definition you learned. Both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Now there are some properties to be discussed here. Parallelogram, you know the properties. Opposite sides will be always equal. Just for an example, this is 5 cm. This also will be 5 cm. If this is 3 cm, this also 3 cm. One first property is opposite sides are equal. The second property is opposite angles also equal. Opposite angles, like this is, if this is 60 degrees, this also 60 degrees. Okay, we know that coincident angle sum is 180. Consider this is a parallel line, this is a transversal. Same side of the transversal, sum is 180. This is 120, this also 120. We know that opposite angles are equal. First property, what we learned, opposite sides are equal. Second property, opposite angles are equal. Next last, which is very important property, diagonals bisect one another. Diagonals, we have two diagonals. For a parallelogram, we have two diagonals. We have diagonals bisect one another, means AO and CO always equal measure. We have another diagonal DO and BO. DO and BO, they are also equal. Diagonals bisect one another. What are the three main properties we learned in parallelogram? Opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisect one another. Okay, next we have the rhombus. Already we have learned properties of trapezium, kite and parallelogram. Now we learn how to define rhombus. Rhombus also a quadrilateral. Rhombus definition of rhombus is, rhombus is also a parallelogram because rhombus also have opposite sides are parallel. But we cannot call trapezium is a parallelogram, kite is a parallelogram, we cannot call. We cannot say that trapezium is a parallelogram, kite is a parallelogram, that is wrong. But we can say rhombus is a parallelogram because rhombus have two pairs of parallel sides, opposite sides are parallel. In rhombus also have opposite sides are parallel. Rhombus is a parallelogram with all its sides are equal. Rhombus is a parallelogram with all its sides are equal. Just an example, I put all sides 5 cm. It's a parallelogram with all four sides are equal. That's rhombus. Now let's come to the properties. Properties of rhombus. Properties of rhombus. Since rhombus is a parallelogram, all the properties of parallelogram applied here in rhombus also. Rhombus says all the properties of parallelogram and also that of kite. In kite, you know, in rhombus, all the properties of parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisect one another. Okay, but rhombus has all the properties of parallelogram with an additional property. What additional property is there? Very useful property in a rhombus. We can take all the properties of rhombus, has all the properties of parallelogram with an additional property. What is additional property? Diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Diagonals are perpendicular to one another. In a rhombus, diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Therefore, we know that in kite also diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Therefore, rhombus has all the properties of a parallelogram and also that of a kite. Very important property which you have to understand in the rhombus, diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Remaining properties are as like parallelogram. Okay. Okay, next quadrilateral we have rectangle. We have already discussed about trapezius and kite, parallelogram, rhombus. We know the rhombus is also a parallelogram because rhombus have both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Even we can say rectangle also parallelogram. Why rectangle also parallelogram? Rectangle is also a parallelogram because rectangle have both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel, like rhombus. Rhombus also have opposite sides are parallel. Even rectangle also have both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. But rectangle we can define in such a way that rectangle is a parallelogram with one right angle. Rectangle is a parallelogram with one right angle. Rectangle is a parallelogram with a right angle. Since it is a parallelogram, we can apply all the properties of a parallelogram. Therefore, rectangle is a parallelogram with a right angle. Since one angle is right angle means we know that since it is a parallelogram, we can take the adjacent angle. Sum will be 180, automatically all the four angles will be 90. It is already a parallelogram. Rectangle is a parallelogram with one right angle. One right angle means definitely all will be right angle. Now we can take the rectangle, all the properties of parallelogram. Rectangle have all the properties of a parallelogram. What is all the properties of parallelogram means what? Opposite sides are equal. If this is 6, this also 6. If this is 4, this also 4. Opposite angles are equal. Since it has 90 degree, all the angles are 90 degree. Opposite angles are definitely equal. Diagonals are bisecting one another. Diagonals are bisect each other. Now, we have to understand one thing. Very, very important property in rectangle. Rectangle has all the properties of a parallelogram with an additional property. With an additional property, diagonals are equal. Rectangle, diagonals are equal. That is the main property which you have to understand from the rectangle. Remaining all the properties are as it like a parallelogram. Okay, we have last one, square. How do you define square? Square have its own properties. Square also have some additional property. Square also we can say it is a parallelogram. Square is also a parallelogram because square have both the opposite sides are parallel. Whose opposite sides are parallel. Even rectangle also parallelogram, rhombus also parallelogram. These all three considered to be a parallelogram. Whereas trapezium and kite is not parallelogram. They have no parallel sides. Opposite sides are not parallel. Even trapezium have one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Square, how will you define? Square is a rectangle with all four sides are equal. Square is a rectangle with all its four sides are equal. Why square is a rectangle? Because square has one angle. Square has all the angles are 90 degree right rectangle. Because square is a rectangle. Because rectangle is also a parallelogram. Definitely square is also a parallelogram. Then while defining, when you define square, you say square is a rectangle with all its four sides are equal. Even square has all the properties of parallelogram with an additional property. Square has some additional properties, one special property is the square. The rectangle has all the properties of parallelogram. Opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisect one another. But in square we have both the diagonals are equal and diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Square, both the diagonals are equal, like a rectangle. Rectangle also both the diagonals are equal. But in here we have diagonals are equal and diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Now we have learned, can you name the two quadrilateral whose diagonals are equal? Already we have discussed, name the two quadrilateral whose diagonals are equal. Well, how do you name that? diagonals are equal. Square and rectangle diagonals are equal. How do you name the two quadrilateral whose diagonals are perpendicular to one another? Where the diagonals are perpendicular to one another? Square and rhombus. In square and rhombus, diagonals are perpendicular to one another. Now name the quadrilateral whose diagonals are bisecting each other, bisecting one another. That happens in parallelogram, rhombus, rectangle, square. Parallelogram, rhombus, rectangle, square. These four quadrilaterals, these four are called, they are called a parallelogram because they have opposite sides are parallel. Okay, now we are given some quadrilaterals here. Trapezium, kite, parallelogram, rhombus. We have discussed about the properties. Already we have discussed about the properties of the different types of quadrilateral. First quadrilateral is trapezium. Trapezium, we have to find the value of this angle. What is the degree measure of x here? We know that trapezium, one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Therefore, coincident angle sum is 180. Here in figure 1, we have x is equal to 190 minus 130. Answer is equal to 50 degree. Angle x is equal to 50 degree. Reason is sum of co-interior angles is 180. What about in kite? Kite we have learned one pair of opposite angles are equal. One pair. This is 140. X also will be 140. They are obtuse angles. One pair of opposite sides are equal. Whereas parallelogram and both the pair of opposite angles are equal. In trapezium, opposite angles are never equal. Co-interior angle sum is 180. Here this is 140. X also 140, x is 140, opposite angles, one pair of opposite angles equal, but whereas this A and C never equal. Now this is a parallelogram. Parallelogram we know sum of the co-interior angles 180. Here also same reason can be written. X is equal to 180 minus 30, x is equal to 50 degree. X is equal to 50 degrees. As the opposite angles are equal, we can take y also 50 degree. Opposite angles are equal. This is a rhombus. Rhombus is a parallelogram. We know that adjacent angle sum is opposite angles equal. Adjacent angle sum is 180. Here x is equal to 180 minus 6. X is equal to 120 degree. This is 120 degree. Definitely y also will be 120 degree. Opposite angles y is also equal to 120 degree. Opposite angles are equal. Rhombus, opposite angles are equal. Okay, next question. We have to find x and y from the figure. We are given some parallelograms. They all are said to be parallelogram because they have rectangle is a parallelogram, rhombus is a parallelogram. They have the common property definition. Opposite sides are, both the pair of opposite sides are parallelogram. You have in each quadrilateral you learned their own properties are there. You know that in a rectangle diagonals are equal. Therefore, we know that since the diagonals are equal, we know that OA, OC, OD, OB, all these four parts are equal. OA, OC, OD, OB. In a rectangle square, diagonals are equal. That's why we know diagonals bisect one another. That's the reason OA, OC, OD, OB equal. OA, OC, OB, OD equal. Since all the they are equal, we can write the equation OB equal to OC. Therefore, 3x plus 1 is equal to 2x plus 4. Therefore, 3x minus 2x is equal to 4 minus 1. Therefore, x is equal to 3. Since x is equal to 3 means we know that how much is the each length of what? What is OA? We have OC is equal to 3 threes are OC is equal to 3 into 3 plus 1. 9 plus 1, 10. This also will be 10. 2 threes are 6. 6 plus 4, 10. Therefore, OA, OC, OB, OD all are equal to 10 centimeter. 3 into 3, 9. 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. Second one, 2 into 3 is 6. 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. Therefore, OA, OB, OC, OD all are equal to 10 cm. Whereas in parallelogram and rhombus, diagonals are not equal. As the diagonals are bisect one another, we can say that OA and OC equal. But whereas here, OA, OB, OC, OD all are equal because they have the equal diagonals. Whereas in parallelogram and rhombus, diagonals are not equal. OA equal to OC. Like this, OB equal to OD. Separately we can find out. First OA equal to OC. What is OA here? 3x plus 1 is equal to 19. 3x 19 minus 1. 3x is equal to 18. We know that x is equal to 18 by 3. X is equal to 6. Therefore x is equal to 6. Now another diagonal we have OD is equal to OB. OD is equal to OB. Therefore 2y minus 1 is equal to 7, 2y is equal to 7 plus 1, 2y is equal to 8, y is equal to 8 by 2 is equal to 4. Here 2y minus 1 is equal to 7, 2y minus 1 is equal to 7, 2y is equal to 7 plus 1 is equal to 8. Therefore the value of y is equal to 8 by 2 is equal to 4. Same property can be applied here also. In the rhombus also diagonals are different length. Diagonals are different length. OA and OC equal. We have x plus 1 is equal to 6. That means OA equal to OC. Therefore, the value of x is equal to 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. Similarly, OB equal to OD. OB equal to OD. We have y plus 2 is equal to 4. Y is equal to 2. That's are the values of x and y. You have to apply the proper different properties in different quadrilateral. Okay, now we are given two quadrilaterals like rectangle and parallelogram given. We know the parallelogram all the opposite sides are, both the face of opposite sides are equal. This is a rectangle. Rectangle is a parallelogram with 190 degree. Here we have opposite sides are equal. To find the value of x, we have to apply the property AB is equal to DC. Opposite sides are equal. 3x plus 5 is equal to 17. 3x is equal to 17 minus 5. 3x is equal to 17 minus 5. 3x is equal to 12. X is equal to 12 by 3. X is equal to 4. Similarly, other pair AD equal to BC. AD equal to AD equal to BC. Here AD 2y minus 3. BC we have 3. Therefore 2y is equal to 3 plus 3. 2y is equal to 6, y is equal to 6 by 2, y is equal to 3. This also parallelogram. Parallelogram have opposite sides are equal. 3x plus 1 is equal to 19. 3x plus 1 is equal to 19. We have 3x is equal to 19 minus 1. 3x is equal to 18. X is equal to 18 by 3. The value of x is equal to 6. To find the value of y, we have other opposite sides. 2y minus 1 is equal to 5. Opposite sides. 2y minus 1 is equal to 5. 2y is equal to 5 plus 1. 2y equal to 6. Y equal to 6 by 2. The value of y is equal to 3. Okay, moving to the next question. We are given some parallelograms. They are all parallelograms. We have to find the degree measure of some of the angles. You have to apply the properties of the parallelograms. We already know that opposite angles of a parallelogram are always equal. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are always equal. Adjacent angles sum is 180. Adjacent angles, they are called co-interior angles. Sum of the co-interior angles always 180. According to the first question we have, this is 130 degree. How will be x? X will be, what will be the degree measure of x here? I think this is a one pair of corresponding angles. That is one pair of corresponding angles. X is equal to 130. X is also equal to 130. They are one pair of corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. Okay. Now, we know that this x and y, they form linear pair. This is a straight line. These two adjacent angles forming a linear pair. Therefore, we know that y is equal to 180 minus 130 is equal to 50. Our reason is linear pair. They form linear pair. Now, we got the value of y. Y we got the 50 degree. The value of y is equal to 50 degree. Now, very easily you can find out z also. Which angle is opposite to y here? Z. Z is opposite to y. Therefore, z is equal to 50. Reason is opposite angles always equal. I think this is also similar type of question. We have here 60 given. And here there are two angles. These two adjacent angles will form linear pair. These two adjacent angles form linear pair. This is 60. Definitely, this will be 180 minus. This will be denoted by A. Let us denote this angle by A. This denote by A. Therefore, A is equal to 180 minus 60. A is equal to 120 degree. This angle is 120 degree. This is 120 degree. The angle opposite to A is what? X. Angle opposite to A is X. Therefore, x is again 120 degree. Okay. Now we have to find out y. Since as this is a parallelogram, you see it is a parallelogram. This 40 is equal to y is equal to 40. How can you write y is equal to 40? They are alternate angles. They are alternate angles. Considering these two parallel lines, this is a transversal. The degree measure of y is also 40. Y is 40. Now finally we have to find out the value of z. Y is equal to 40, x is equal to 120, y is equal to 40. Why x is equal to 120? Opposite angles equal. Now y is equal to 40, reason is alternate interior angles. Now we have to apply the there is a triangle here. We have the two angles degree measure we know. This is 120, this is 40. We will find the third angle. This is a triangle. Z is equal to 180 minus 120 plus 40. 180 minus 160 we have 20 degree. Therefore, Z is equal to 20 degree. 20 degree. We got the all the degree measure of X, Y and Z. Same method can be done here also. This is 70. Then they are linear pair. They form linear pair. This angle can be denoted by A. Therefore, A is equal to 110. 180 minus 70 what? 180 minus 70? 110. This is 110. Here also we have 110. Opposite angles are equal. Now we have here 40 means this also 40. Y is equal to 40. Now finally, we have to find the value of Z. Z means this is, consider this a triangle. We know this is a triangle. Taking this triangle, we can find the value of Z. Z is equal to 180 minus 110 plus 40. 180 minus 150, we got the value of Z is equal to 30. Okay, these are the values of X by Z. X already we got here 110, Y value is 40, Z value is equal to 30. Okay, now we have come to the end of the lesson. I hope you have understood the basic idea very clearly. So please do not forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.